Hello everybody, Andrea Myeski here with Dentalelle Mobile Hygiene. So let's talk about the differences of the sensitivity toothpastes on the market. So if your teeth are cold sensitive, you have probably at some point, hopefully, been told by your dental hygienist that you should switch your toothpaste. That is the first thing to do and the easiest thing to do to help your teeth against the sensitivity. But you also have to know why the teeth are sensitive in the first place. Is it because you were brushing too hard for a number of years where a portion of the enamel has been taken off and the second layer of your tooth is now exposed? Or is it because you are still brushing too hard so that protective layer that comes back doesn't have a chance to really form? Is it because you haven't had your teeth cleaned in 10 years where the inflammation around the teeth is causing things to be sensitive? So there's many different reasons. Even if you clench your teeth at nighttime, that could be making the teeth very, very sensitive and a toothpaste won't help you. So you do have to know why your teeth are sensitive. And if you don't know, your dental hygienist can help you with that. But not all toothpastes are the same for sensitivity. What I want you guys all to look out for if you are buying a sensitivity type of toothpaste is look for the key ingredient called potassium nitrate. So I'll say it again, potassium nitrate. That is the key ingredient that you want, and not all toothpastes have it. Even if a toothpaste claims to help with sensitivity, if it doesn't contain potassium nitrate, it won't do much. It might still help, but it's not the best kind to get. You know, it's kind of like, oh darn, I can't really think of an example. Well, I kind of can. There are many different toothbrushes, right, out there on the market. If you get a toothbrush that falls apart, well, it's not really a very good toothbrush, is it? You might have a toothbrush, but if it's a hard toothbrush that might just fall apart, well, that's not helping you. You want to get a soft toothbrush to really do the best, if that makes sense. Horrible example, but you know. So not all sensitivity types of toothpaste are equal to the same. I'm not going to mention names, but the ones that I prefer for my patients would be either the Sensodyne, that's my favorite, or the Colgate Sensitive. Okay, so either the Sensodyne or the Colgate Sensitive. Those ones include potassium nitrate in it, among other things too. But you want that key ingredient, because what potassium nitrate actually does is we have nerves inside our teeth. Those nerves have what's called tubules that lead to those nerves. Some toothpaste out there just simply cover up those tubules. And the toothpaste works, but not long-term. Whereas with potassium nitrate, those toothpastes help to cover up the tubules and help to seal them off. So they will actually close up those tubules. When the tubules are open, that's what causes the sensitivity. So does that make sense? So that's why it's so important to get the right toothpaste. I like Sensodyne and Colgate Sensitive. Those are the best ones from what I've seen for my patients because they contain potassium nitrate. And if you're going to switch the toothpaste, you might as well get the right one or it won't help you. And the key is to brush every day, twice a day for a good 2 minutes. If your teeth are really, really sensitive, I do also tell my patients with a Q-tip or your finger, take some of that toothpaste off at nighttime and just sort of like put it on your teeth that are the most sensitive. So like here, 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 and don't, you know, brush it off. Let that sit overnight while you sleep, and that will help that protective layer sort of come up even quicker, and that is what you want. So I hope this helped answer some questions about sensitivity. If you guys have any questions, let me know, and thank you so much for watching.